Today we're looking at the depth chart, specifically in the wide receiver room, and it's a doozy. Let's talk Lions. Welcome back. Thank you for liking this video, for tossing your thoughts in the comments. In fact, Mitch Elston here said, "Greetings, algorithm. Please share this video with others." Well, thanks, Mitch. I appreciate it. You doing that actually does help. Weirdly, that's the word on the street, at least. I don't know. I mean, I'm just trusting what other people are saying. So that's how a lot of people get into danger. Though now that I'm thinking about it, we are working our way through the depth chart. We've already done QBs. Today, we are looking at the wide receiver room. Now, the first thing I wanted to do was have a quick side-by-side comparison from the 2020 wide receiver room and the 2021 receiver room here in Detroit. In 2020, the Detroit Lions had Kenny Golladay, Marvin Jones Jr., Marvin Deep Ball Hall, Danny Amendola, Quintus Cephas, Mohamed Sanu, Jamal Agnew, and Geronimo Allison, who opted out. On the practice squad, they had Tom Kennedy and Victor Bolden. You look at that squad and you compare it to who we have this year, it's insane, the turnover. And you already know that, but in case you don't, that's all right. The 2021 room is as follows: Terrell Williams, Breshad Perriman, Quintus Cephas, Damian Ratley, Geronimo Allison, Javon McKinley, Jonathan Adams, Sage Surratt, Amon-Ra St. Brown, Khalif Raymond, Tom Kennedy, and Victor Bolden. Now, most of these names are new. Scratch Kenny Golladay off the list. Get rid of Marvin Hall. Get rid of Marvin Jones Jr. Get rid of Danny Amendola. You're looking at an entirely revamped active roster. Now, a couple of the names that you'll see coming over on the practice squad are between Victor Bolden and Tom Kennedy. Those guys never saw action last year on the practice squad. Here they are again this year. The other two names from that list of 2020 is Quintus Cephas and Geronimo Allison. Geronimo Allison opted out of 2020, so he didn't even see the light of day. He was like the brave little toaster out there, just trying to find his way, but didn't really, not successful. So there is only one wide receiver from the 2020 squad that is coming into 2021, and that is Quintus Cephas. Other than that, at the moment, there are 12 wide receivers listed on the depth chart for the Detroit Lions this year. Of all those 12, only one saw any playing time while in Honolulu Blue last year, which is just a wild, wild thought. This wide receiver room is basically brand new. Now, teams usually run with 6 wide receivers on their active roster and about max 3 wide receivers on the practice squad. So that's a total of 9 guys. And the Detroit Lions are sitting at 12 in this offseason. So what does that mean? Well, the Lions are going to be getting rid of a few. So who will they be? Just want to give you some basic understanding in case you don't know much about the active roster versus the practice squad. The active roster on a weekly basis during the season has 53 men on it. Basically just a bunch of Vikings rowing their boat over to enemy territory, going to pillage the land. But then each team also has a practice squad. Now coming into the 2021 season, each team should have 12 guys on the practice squad. However, due to COVID, that number could increase. It could be 16, it could be more, it could be less. Kind of unsure due to the pandemic. According to the NFL, in the 2021 season, each team at this moment will have 12 guys on the practice squad. So I really think that the Lions are only going to use 3 of those slots for wide receivers. We already have 12 coming into this offseason. You have 6 on your active 53-man roster, and maybe you hold on to 3 other guys, and you take young guys, you put them on the practice squad, and you develop them. That's going to be your Sage Surratt. That's going to be your McKinley. That's going to be these young guys that you're bringing in that aren't quite ready enough yet to get out on the field and make the plays. Looking at our wide receiver core today, my prediction for the Detroit Lions is that we will have the following 6 guys on the active roster: Terrell Williams, Breshad Perriman, Quintus Cephas, Damian Ratley, Amon-Ra St. Brown, and Jonathan Adams. Then you bounce over to the practice squad, and I've got Khalif Raymond, Javon McKinley, and Geronimo Allison. So you're all wondering, what about Sage Surratt? I think that Surratt's going to be kind of that toss-up guy. Will he make it? Will he not? At the moment, I have him as no. But we're going to see as OTAs unfold. As we get a look at training camp, we'll have a better picture. But today, out of those 12 guys, those are the six that I have on the active roster and the three that I believe will be on the practice squad. Now listen, Sage Surratt could come out and blow us away. A lot of these guys could be moved around. One of these guys getting cut, especially those undrafted free agents. We picked up some really solid picks. However, I don't see all three of them making it. When I'm looking at our active roster and those six guys, between Williams, Perriman, Cephas, Adams, St. Brown, and Ratley, when I see those guys, some of my thoughts are Breshad Perriman is now linking back up with Antoine Randle-L. Obviously, Randle-L was his coach in Tampa Bay. I think that combination of them, again, could prove successful. I think Perriman with the Jets, it was just, he was stuck with the Jets. He was stuck with Sam Darnold throwing ducks. Well, now you have a guy like Goff who can actually get the ball to his wide receivers, who is accurate, and I look at him, and I look at the pairing with Perriman, and I see possible success. Terrell Williams being that wide receiver one, he was injured out all last season. I believe those two guys, my mild salsa take is the fact that Perriman and Williams will come out here and ball out for the Detroit Lions. Because Williams was hurt and out for an entire season, a lot of people just sort of forgot about him. He's not on the top of any list. He's not on anybody's minds. But when I look at Williams, I see a guy who can create separation, who's fast, and will make plays for our offense. Cephas is coming into year two with the Lions. He now has good leadership. He's now got great coaches and coordinators around him. And I think that's going to prove great for him. Looking at Amon-Ra St. Brown, put him in the slot. That is where he will make the most impact for the Lions. And then Jonathan Adams. You have your big-bodied receiver that you can put on the outside, replicate some of that Kenny G type of stuff. Now, granted, you know, I think Kenny Golladay was phenomenal. I'm not saying Jonathan Adams is Kenny Golladay, but I think he can replicate some of that style of play. Put him on the outside. That's where you'll see him go, bombing down the field for some deep balls. I'm looking forward to it. Those practice squad guys are really going to be jockeying for a spot, A, on the practice squad, but then B, to level up to make it onto the starting roster. Between Khalif Raymond, Javon McKinley, and Geronimo Allison, I think those are going to be the three guys, unless Sage Surratt really surprises us in training camp. Just my thoughts, though. How do you feel? Who are your six that you believe the Detroit Lions will have on the 53-man roster? Drop your thoughts in the comments. I look forward to reading it. And as always, I'll catch you next time on Let's Talk Lions.